Hello, welcome back to Python tutorial lessons. In this new lesson, we are going to use user-defined function a bit more detail, and we will be using a if-else construct, selection construct within a user-defined function, so that we can use both if and user-defined function a more constructive way. So in the previous example of if else statements, we have seen every time we have to give different values, and again we have to check for the condition, and the coding was embarrassing, and we have to do the coding again and again, especially when we are doing it in the interactive mode or in the interpreter mode. Even if it is in the programming mode, in a program itself, if you have some group of statements, if it is repeated in the same sequence, and if it is required at many places in our programming code, so we will be using function to reduce the coding. We will declare the code, we will define the code or define the function in a place and assign a name to the function, and just by referring the function name we will be using it. Let us see, start with an example. So we are having a function here. The name of the function is odd underscore even, and here the things which are all coming directly under this function, it is having a single tab space, and the things coming under if, one extra tab space, and else is not under if, it's a part of the if construct block, so it is having only one tab which is required to state that if is coming under the definition statement, and this print is coming under else because it is having two tabs here. So odd even is a function, it will read a value, an integer value from the user using input statement, and it is typecasted with int typecast. So it will be reading a value of integer, and x will be having an integer value. Here we are checking the value of x, whether x is perfectly divisible by 2 or not. If it is perfectly divisible, then the answer will be 0. So then this if statement or the conditional expression will give a true value. If it is 0, then it will print the value ended or the value in x is even. Or if it is not perfectly divisible, that means if it is having a remainder, then the else block of code will be executed. That means the value ended is an odd number. So definition is done. This is definition for the function. So whenever we want to use it, we can call the function. The name of the function is odd even. Please enter an integer, it is asking for a value, I am going to give 3, and let me execute it once again. When 3 is given, it said the this is an odd number. So let me give another number, even number. Yeah, it is giving this is an even number. So function is working, function is functioning perfectly in this example. If you want, we can have another trial as well. A little modification with the function, so that without having this input statement, we can directly assign the value of x through an argument here. So when we call, we can call it with an argument. We will try it later, maybe in the next lesson. Bye. Thank you for watching this video. Please do subscribe the channel for getting more videos from this channel. Have a nice day. Bye.